Good morning, friends. I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And this is lecture number 106 on the module conduction heat transfer. The topic for today's discussion is steady state heat transfer in a cylinder. We solve few problems on this topic. We recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we discussed the one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder and a composite cylinder. We also discussed the electrical analogy for a cylinder, and we derived the thermal resistance for the cylinder, and we solved a few problems on the composite cylinder. And in this lecture, the learning outcome, at the end of this lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the composite cylinder using the thermal resistance concept for the cylinder. So, in continuation to the previous lecture, we take the example number 3. Steam at 350 degrees Celsius flowing in a pipe. The material thermal conductivity of the pipe material is 80 watts per meter Kelvin of 5 centimeter inner diameter. And 5.6 centimeter outer diameter is covered with 3 centimeter thick insulation of thermal conductivity 0.05 watts per meter Kelvin. Heat is lost to the surrounding at 5 degrees Celsius by natural convection radiation. The combined heat transfer coefficient is 20 watts per meter square Kelvin. The taking the heat transfer coefficient inside the pipeline for the steam is 60. Watts per meter square Kelvin. Determine the rate of heat loss from the steam per unit length of the pipe. So, this is a composite cylinder of two layers. The first layer is the pipe material and the second layer is the insulation. Inside the composite pipe, the steam is flowing, and outside the composite pipe, we have the air which is flowing with the temperature TO and the heat transfer coefficient HO. The steam temperature is Ti and the heat transfer coefficient is Hi. And for the first layer steel pipe, inner radius is R1, outer radius is R2. And for the insulation, the outer radius is R3. K1 is the thermal conductivity of the pipe material and K2 is the thermal conductivity of the insulating powder. And these are all the given data. Inner radius of the steel pipe is 0.025 meter. So, we are given the diameter as 5 centimeter, the radius is 0.025 meter and the outer radius R2 equal to, it is given as 5.6 centimeter, diameter is 5.6 centimeter and here radius equal to 0.028 meter and R3 equal to 0.058 meter. K1, thermal conductivity of the pipe material is 80 watts per meter Kelvin and thermal conductivity of the insulation is 0.05 watts per meter Kelvin. Inside heat transfer coefficient is 60 watts per meter square Kelvin and the temperature of the steam is 350 degrees Celsius. Outside heat transfer coefficient is 20 watts per meter square Kelvin and the temperature is 5 degrees Celsius. And this is what the corresponding thermal resistance circuit. Ti is the steam temperature, To is the air temperature, Ri is the resistance due to the convection on the inner side, R1 is the resistance due to the pipe material, R2 is the resistance due to the insulating material and RO is the resistance on the convection resistance on the outside air. So, we calculate the values of the resistances. The inside resistance is 1 by A into Hi, 2 pi R1 into L into Hi is equal to 1 by 2 pi into R1 equal to 0.025, length equal to 1 meter, Hi equal to 60. So, this will be 0.106 Kelvin per watts. And R1, the insulation due to the pipe material, 1 by 2 pi K1 into L into logarithmic of R2 by R1, which is 1 by 2 pi into 80 into 1 into logarithmic of 0.028 divided by 0.025 equal 2.25 10 power minus 4 Kelvin by watts. And R2 is the resistance due to the insulation, which is 1 by 2 pi K2 into L into logarithmic of R3 by R2, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi into 0.05 into 1 into logarithmic of 0.058 divided by 0.028, which is 2.32 Kelvin by watts. and the convection resistance on the outside air 1 by 2 pi R3 into L into HO, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi 0.058 into 1 into 20, which is 0.137 Kelvin per watts. The rate of heat transfer Q equal to the extreme temperature difference Ti minus To divided by sum of all the resistances Ri plus R1 plus R2 plus RO. Substituting the numerical values, Q equal to 350 minus 5 divided by 0.106 plus 2.25 10 power minus 4 plus 2.32 plus 0.137 equal to 134.6 watts. So the amount of heat transfer, rate of heat transfer is 134.6 watts. And the surface temperature, we take Q equal to Ti minus T1 divided by the corresponding resistance, Ti minus T1 divided by Ri. So from this equation, T1 equal to Ti minus Q into Ri, substituting the values, T1 equal to 350 minus 134.6 into 0.106, which is 335.7 degrees Celsius. And Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1. So from here, T2 equal to T1 minus Q into R1, which is equal to 335.7 minus 134.6 into 2.25 10 power minus 4, which is 335.67 degrees Celsius. And to calculate T3, Q equal to T2 minus T3 divided by R2. So T3 equal to T2 minus Q into R2, which is 335.67 minus 134.6 into 2.32, which is 23.4 degrees Celsius. The answers for the problem: rate of heat transfer Q equal to 134.6 watts, intermediate temperature, surface temperature T1 equal to 335.7 and T2 equal to 335.67 and T3 equal to 23.4 degree Celsius. So you write the, at the end of every problem, you write the answers so that the it is useful for you in future. And we take example number 4. This is again from the Anna University question paper. A steel tube of 5 cm ID inner diameter, 7.6 cm outer diameter, and K equal to thermal conductivity equal to 15 watts per meter Kelvin is covered with an insulation of thickness 2 cm with K equal to 0.2 watts per meter Kelvin. Hot gases at 330 degrees Celsius with the heat transfer coefficient 400 watts per meter square Kelvin flows inside the tube. The outer surface of the insulation is exposed to the cooler air at 30 degrees Celsius with the heat transfer coefficient H equal to 60 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate heat loss from the tube to the air for 10 meter of the tube and the temperature drop resulting from the thermal resistance of hot gas flow, steel tube, insulating layer and outside air. And this is again first layer is the steel tube, second layer is the insulation, and here inside we have the gas at temperature Ti and the heat transfer coefficient Hi, and outside we have the air at temperature To and the heat transfer coefficient HO. So these are the given data. R1 inner radius R1 equal to 0.025 meter, R2 equal to 0.038 meter, R3 equal to 0.058 meter, and K1 equal to thermal conductivity of the material, pipe material, is 15 watts per meter Kelvin, and insulation is K2 equal to 0.2 watts per meter Kelvin. Heat transfer coefficient inside is 400 watts per meter square Kelvin, and inside temperature is 330 degrees Celsius. Outside heat transfer coefficient is 60 watts per meter square Kelvin, and outside air temperature is 60 degrees Celsius, and length of the tube is 10 meter. And this is the thermal resistance circuit. Ti is the temperature of the gas and To is the temperature of the air. Ri is the resistance due to the gas. R1 is the resistance due to the steel tube material and R2 is the resistance due to the insulation and RO is the resistance, convection resistance due to the airflow outside the pipeline. And once again we calculate the thermal resistances. Ri in the same equation 1 by 2 pi R1 into L into H1, which is 1 by 2 pi into 0.025 into length equal to 10 meter. And H A equal to 400, which is 1.59 10 power minus 3. R1 equal to 1 by 2 pi K1 into L logarithmic of R2 by R1, which is 1 by 2 pi into 15 into 10 in the logarithmic of 0.038 divided by 0.025, which is 4.44 10 power minus 4. R2 equal to 1 by 2 pi K2 into L logarithmic of R3 by R2, which is 1 by 2 pi into 0.2 into 10 into logarithmic of 0.058 divided by 0.038, which is 0.0337, and RO outside resistance equal to 1 by 2 pi R3 into L into HO, which is 1 by 2 pi into 0.058 into 10 into 60, which is 4.57 10 power minus 3 Kelvin per watts. And the rate of heat transfer, Q equal to TI minus TO divided by all the resistances RI plus RO or RI plus R1 plus R2 plus RO. Substituting the numerical values, 330 minus 30 divided by 1.59 10 power minus 3 plus 4.44 10 power minus 4 plus 0.0337 plus 4.57 10 power minus 3, which is equal to 7443.4 watts. That is what the amount of heat transfer, rate of heat transfer in the composite pipe. And temperature drop to the hot gases, Ti minus T1 equal to Q into Ri, which is 7443.4 into 1.59 10 power minus 3 is equal to 11.83 degree Celsius. And temperature drop across the steel tube, T1 minus T2 equal to Q into R1, which is 7443.4 into 4.4 into 10 power minus 4, which is 33 degree Celsius. And heat temperature drop in the insulation, T2 minus T3 equal to Q into R2, which is 7443.4 into 0.0337 equal to 250.84 degree Celsius. And the temperature drop due to the convection of air, T3 minus TO equal to Q into RO, which is 7443.4 into 4.57 10 power minus 3 equal to 34 degree Celsius. The answers of the problem are: rate of heat transfer equal to 7443.4 watts. Temperature drop for the hot gases 11.83 degree Celsius. For the steel tube 33 degree Celsius. Insulation 250.84 degree Celsius. And outside air 34 degree Celsius. And we take the fifth problem. A 150 mm steam pipe has inside diameter 120 mm and outside diameter 160 mm. It is insulated at the outside with the asbestos. The steam temperature is 150 degrees Celsius and the air temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. The heat transfer coefficient on the steam side is 100 watts per meter square Kelvin and the air side is 100 watts per meter square Kelvin. Thermal conductivity of asbestos equal to 0.8 watts per meter Kelvin and the steel is 42 watts per meter Kelvin. How thick should be the asbestos to be provided in order to limit the heat losses to 2.1 kilowatts per meter? This question is also from Anna University question paper in November 2012. And this is the arrangement of the pipe. We have a steel pipe. One is the steel pipe, two is the insulation. And the steam is flowing inside and the air is flowing outside. And this is what the resistance circuit. Ri is the resistance due to the steam, R1 is the resistance due to the steel pipe material, and R2 is insulation due to the insulation, and RO is the resistance due to the air. And these are all the data given. R1 is given as 120 millimeter, diameter is given as 120 millimeter, and R1 equal to 0.06 meter, R2 equal to 0.08 meter, and we have to calculate R3. R3 is the unknown here. K1 is the thermal conductivity of the pipe material, 42 watts per meter Kelvin, and K2 is the thermal conductivity of the asbestos, 0.8 watts per meter Kelvin. Hi is the heat transfer coefficient inside, 100 watts per meter square Kelvin. Ti is the temperature of the steam inside, which is 150 degree Celsius. HO is the heat transfer coefficient outside, which is again 100 watts per meter square Kelvin. And TO is the air temperature, which is 20 degree Celsius. So we are given the steam length of the steam pipe is 0.15 meter and the heat transfer is 2.1 kilowatts per meter length of the pipeline. The question here, we have to find out the thickness of the asbestos insulation. So once you know the R3 value, you can calculate thickness equal to R3 minus R2. So the value of the resistances, Ri, inside resistance due to the steam flow, 1 by 2 pi R1 into L into Hi, which is 1 by 2 pi into 0.06 into 0.15 into 100, which is 0.177 Kelvin by watt. and r1 equal to 1 by 2 pi k1 into l into logarithmic of r2 by r1, which is 1 by 2 pi into 42 into 0.15 into logarithmic of 0.08 divided by 0.06, which is equal to 7.27 10 power minus 3 Kelvin by watts, and r2 equal to 1 by 2 pi k2 into l logarithmic of r3 by r2, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi into 0.8 into 0.15, which is logarithmic of r3 divided by 0.08, which is 1.327 into logarithmic of r3 divided by 0.08. r3 is the unknown here. And r2 equal to, so from here, r2 equal to 1.327 into logarithmic of r3 minus 1.327 in logarithmic of 0.08 is minus 2.526. So this is equal to 1.327 logarithmic of r3 plus 3.35. And ro equal to 1 by 2 pi 2 pi r3 into l into ho, which is 1 by 2 pi r3 into 0.15 into 100, which is equal to 0.0106 divided by r3. So the rate of heat transfer, we are given q equal to 2.1 kilowatts per meter. So 2.1 into 1000 into per meter. So you have to convert into calculate for the length of the pipe 0.15 meter. So 2.1 into 1000 into 0.15 equal to the temperature difference Ti minus To divided by sum of all the resistances. So this equation, left hand side is 315, right hand side Ti minus To divided by Ri plus R1 plus R2 plus RO. So substituting the numerator, T 150 minus 20, R1 is known as 0.177, Ri is known as 0.177, R1 is 7.27 10 power minus 3, R2 equal to 1.327 into logarithmic of R3 plus 3.35, and RO equal to 0.0106 divided by R3. And so the cross multiplying, you take this value to the left side and 315 to the right side. So all these values equal to 115 minus 20 divided by 315. So this is mathematically simplifying. So the unknown 1.327 logarithmic of R3 plus 0.0106 divided by R3 equal to 150 minus 20 divided by 315 minus 0.177 minus 7.27 10 power minus 3 minus 3.35. Simplifying the right hand side, it is going to be minus of 3.12. Now there are two, actually R3 is the variable. This is logarithmic function. This is 1 by R3. So we have to solve it by trial and error method. So what is trial and error method? You substitute the value of R3 above R2. R2 value already we know, R2 value is given as, what is R2 value is given as 0.08 meter. So above 0.08, you take some value 0.084, 0.085, 0.086, 0.087 and 0.088. You take different values of R3 and substitute here, find out the left hand side and check the value on the right hand side. So the left hand side value and right hand side value should be equal. So if you substitute R3 equal to 0.087, so in the left hand side, we will be getting minus 3.12. So this is the correct answer. So this is what the trial and error method. So you substitute values for R3 in the left hand side, verify the answer, and it should tally with the value on the right hand side. So thickness of the asbestos insulation is equal to R3 minus R2, which is equal to 0.087 minus 0.08 equal to 0.0007 meter, which is 7 millimeter. That is the thickness of the insulation. So the answer for the problem, thickness of the asbestos insulation is 7 millimeter. And we take another example, which is also from the university question paper. A 3 centimeter outside diameter steam pipe is to be covered with two layers of insulation, each having thickness of 2.5 centimeter. The average thermal conductivity of one insulation is 5 times that of other. Determine the percentage of decrease in heat transfer if better insulation material is next to the pipe than it is the outer layer. Assume the outside inside temperature of the composite insulations are fixed. So this is the arrangement. We have two pipes, R1, R2, R3 are the radiuses of the pipe surface. K1 is thermal conductivity of the inside pipe and K2 is thermal conductivity of the outside pipe. And we have the R1 equal to 0.015 meter, R2 equal to 0.04 meter, and R3 equal to 0.065 meter. And we have two thermal conductivity, one of 5K, another one is K. So, material of higher thermal conductivity near the pipe, that is the arrangement. That means K1 equal to 5K and K2 equal to K. So, substituting R1 is 1 by 2 pi K1 into L into logarithmic of R2 by R1, which is 1 by 2 pi into 5K into 1 into logarithmic of 0.04 divided by 0.015 is equal to 0.03 divided by K. And R2 equal to 1 by 2 pi K2 into L logarithmic of R3 by R2, which is 1 by 2 pi K into L, L equal to 1 meter into logarithmic of 0.065 divided by 0.04 equal to 0.077 divided by K. And rate of heat transfer, substituting Q equal to delta T by R1 plus R2, substituting for R1 and R2, delta T divided by 0.03 divided by K plus 0.07 divided by K, that gives 9.345 delta T into K. So, here when better insulating material, higher thermal conductivity, material of higher thermal conductivity is inside, then this is the heat transfer. Then material of lower thermal conductivity, material of lower thermal conductivity near the pipeline. So, that is K1 equal to 5 and K2 equal to 5K. So, here once again R1 equal to 1 by 2 pi K1 into L logarithmic of R2 by R1, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi K1 into L into logarithmic of 0.04 divided by 0.015 equal to 0.156 by K, and R2 equal to 1 by 2 pi K2 into L logarithmic of R3 by R2, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi 5K into 1 into logarithmic of 0.065 divided by 0.04 equal to 0.0155 divided by K. And here the rate of heat transfer, in the same way we calculate delta T divided by R1 plus R2, delta T divided by 0.156 divided by K plus 0.0155 divided by K, which is equal to delta T divided by 0.1715 divided by K. Calculating, this will be 5.83 into delta T into K. Now, percentage of decrease in heat transfer, if better insulating material is near the pipeline, this is 9.345 delta T K minus 5.83 delta T K divided by 9.345 delta T K into 100. This will be 37.6%. So, the decrease in heat transfer equal to 37.6%. The answer for the problem, the percentage decrease in heat transfer if better insulating material is near the pipeline, which is equal to 37.6%. And this is all the reference book I used for preparation of the note, preparation of the slides. You can refer to it for further clarification. I have written a book on the subject, Heat and Mass Transfer, published by Anuradha Publications. You can reach to the book so that you will get additional problems on the same topic. And if you have any queries on the subject or on the topic what we discussed today, you can write to me, to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to all your queries. And thank you. We'll meet again.